just before I start, I just Googled something like some statistic which told me that in India we have a mobile penetration of 53%, and it is expected to go by 56% end of the year 2030. But in that 53%, smartphone users are only 20%, that too in the top five urban cities: Delhi, Mumbai, Calcutta, Chennai, and Bangalore. So rest of the 80% in this five cities are using normal phones, which are not smartphones. The another interesting fact is that in India, internet penetration is only 15%. That's interesting. So what our government of Maharashtra did is definitely an extension of what Kavita ji has mentioned in her presentation, is we have used these numbers to reach to as many as people we could in the state of Maharashtra. So what we did is over the period of last 7-8 months is we used the SMS feature, simple basic SMS feature, to reach to as many as people in Maharashtra. So how UID program, like NAREGA program, like there are so many RTO transport related, health related NEGP programs are there, so that a lot of people are aware of these programs. So that's why we use SMS stuff. How we could do that? We push the SMS, like any citizen is applying for his UID application. So what is the status of the application? He has to come to the UID center. That center cannot give the data. He has to come to a nodal office. Then only he will get the status of his UID. Or he has to log in internet. But as I mentioned, only 15% penetration. So we are sending SMS data. Okay, your UID status is right now this. So this is the push application we used to let the citizens know what is the status of your application. I'm just talking about UID. But in a lot of cases, like in transport, you apply for a driver's license, you applied for a vehicle license, vehicle registration. All kind of details have been, all kind of status update are given to the citizen by this push technology. So another thing, means I'm keeping it very short, broadly. Another thing is the pull technology. Like somebody mentioned, like if somebody wants to know what is the status of some application, but the government can't give that information to this because it is restricted information. So government will ask for a particular registration number from that citizen. Then only I can give that information. So we have incorporated both the push technology and the pull technology in our whole applications. All the applications DIT, Department of IT, Government of Maharashtra is developing. Moving forward, like you can see, what are the just to brief you, salient features of this SMS gateway is simple. It's a new user creation, then authentication, all these security issues are definitely there. Then all of these technological issues, I'm not going into these technological issues. Now, moving to this, as I mentioned, this slide, push services. In push services, we have two things. One is we have developed application, UI applications, where citizens can log in and get their information in their mobile phone. Another one is the web services utility, where the technology we are incorporating the SMS gateways is in the application itself, so that once you apply, you directly get, like what happens when we book our tickets through cleartrip.com or makemytrip.com. Through those, in our applications, we are incorporating those features, SMS gateway features. So this is the architecture, the simple architecture of how the SMS gateway works. You see, on the left side of yours, it's all the operators are working. On the right hand side is the applications, all our application. And we are building MOL is Maha Online, which is DIT's, Government of Maharashtra's application developers. So they have developed this technology using web services, XML files, so that to to incorporate this gateway. Now, okay, one thing is, as I at the very beginning I mentioned, why we need this thing, why we need SMS gateway. It sounds very simple, but last slide of mine, you can see internet penetration is only 15% in India, but mobile penetration is almost 52% March 2013. So that's why SMS gateways make a major difference in citizens' life in India. Thank you very much.
Thank you.